he and I don't talk near as much as we should, but we both are very adamant where we stand on this one. The impact that we're going to face is anything less than a hospital designation under the current rural health system, anything short of a hospital, quote, H designation, we will not be able to get reimbursement if we take patients to that facility. That is the way it is. I mean, I've called Medicare, Medicaid, I've called Blue Cross Blue Shield, all the other providers that we have, and they've all made the same comment. Whatever Medicare does, we do. Medicare is very specific. It's got to have an H hotel designation, which is hospital.
In relation to dragging a person to the facility?
Yes, sir. As far as getting reimbursement to the facility or taking someone to the facility, which is what, let's face it, does keep EMS afloat in a lot of cases. Now, that all that being said, if this clinic is not located closer to the population base under which it's being served, that population base being Hyde County, Antigo Township, and a big chunk of Bath Township, because we take patients, Pamlico EMS takes 90% of their patients to Bungo. Bath Community EMS takes 60 to 65% of their patients to Bungo. Of course, our current tenant up in Bellhaven, White Oak, is, I'd say 99%, because occasionally they've taken someone over to Plymouth and to Beaufort County Hospital because it was the two closest medical, it was the closest medical facility for which those people live. That is the requirement. We take an individual to the closest medical facility that can meet their needs. Now, that being said, clinic is not one of those if you're going to go for reimbursement. I will say this. If it means a patient's life and we've got to stop off at a clinic to get them stabilized, that EMS would do that. And we'll worry about reimbursement later, because that's our obligation. And his and my oath to the people, mine to Beaufort County, his to Hyde County. And so I want to address the further away you get from that Pantico Township, from Pantico and Bellhaven, towards Washington. It's not going to help us a whole lot. We're going to get to a point where we're transporting people if we're bringing them down 264. By the time we stop, we could do more harm. Our protocols are very specific that we work under the North Carolina protocols. State OEMS has made it very clear that yes, we can take a patient to there, but our medical director, Dr. Emily Penley, who works in the emergency room here in Washington, is just as concerned as everyone else about if we stop somewhere, we have to make sure they have all the things they need and it's best for the patient. So we're going to have to wait until the final is out on the clinic as far as what we could do to stop off at a clinic in the future. If it's got a hotel designation, it does, we can stop and get reimbursement. We'll stop where the people are getting the best care. We know they're not going to have a burn center, so we're going to go on right on past the clinic unless we're stopping at the helipad to Beaufort. That's what we'll do with a burn, because they'll have no capability of dealing with a burn patient there at the current, my current understanding of what the clinic's going to be able to do. Pungo transfers all burn patients. They immediately start setting up. The minute they find out a burn patient's coming in there, they're immediately setting up air transport or some other form of transport to take them on from providing Pungo right now.
Sean, everything that you're bringing up needs to be laid out into a document by yourself. And if you would, put all these concerns together in relation to the meeting that county commissioners will be attending next week, and the city council of Bellhaven, and whoever might be going with us, so we can take that particular list with us. But I would suggest to the county manager that John get all this information organized and put together into a document, and that he would present it at the next county manager's meeting so we can look at it in an organized fashion, if John would so agree to do so.
Yes, sir. The only other point I would make is the turnaround time for ambulances is going to be extreme. During an interim between an ED or any other form of service, we're going to go from a 7-minute to a 20-minute, which is what it's been for the patients that White Oak has picked up, that they're in Pungo District Hospital. the turnaround, if we have to get a payment to each patient out and take it, is over 2 hours. Justin's going to face turnarounds of up to 3 hours for the people out of Icahn for his ambulances. And therefore, initially, I can already say that if that ED closes, I'm immediately going to have to turn around to the county commission and ask for $250,000 to put another ambulance team on duty in Bellhaven to provide two ambulances there of the eye level, intermediate level, to try to preserve life the best we can.
Please put together an anticipated cost, too. Does any county commissioners have any comments or input on this particular subject?
Of course not. The reimbursement that you're getting now, you said it's going to be affected. What is the dollar amount that you're talking about?
Whitehead EMS is...
We talk about the countywide.
Well,
this one move is going to affect the whole county.
Currently, the volunteer squads that are involved are not charging for their services. So there will be no impact to them. White Oak, if they hold all their patients to a clinic, you're talking as much as $100,000. If they were able to collect what's over, which we know that's not always going to happen.
That's just the White Oak and the Pungo.
Yes, sir, but they run the majority of the runs.
Okay.
But we're talking 500 patients.
500.
Oh, you're not through?
No.
I'm sorry. Go ahead.
So you're talking about, so that $100,000 will affect just that red group?
The White Oak group, yes, sir, because they're the only ones currently charging.
They take care of Pantiga and the Bellhaven area.
Yes, sir, plus they do mutual aid in the Bath and Pamlico Beach. If the volunteer squads can't get anybody there, White Oak is the one that goes down all the way to Pamlico Beach, picks that patient up and brings them back to Pungo.
If they have to bring somebody to Washington, you said the turnaround is 2 hours.
It'll be 2 hours plus if we have to go to Pamlico Beach, pick the patient up, take them here to Washington, and by the time ambulance gets back to Bellhaven, they will have exceeded 2 hours, just as, you know, I County will exceed well over 3 hours in some cases.
Anything else? I apologize, Ed. I can't hardly hear out of my left ear anymore. I apologize. Commissioner Brent, do you have any? Belcher?
Okay. I got one thing to say.
Yes, sir.
I thought we got a dog in this hunt, don't we?
Yes, sir. It should be pointed out, too, I've been to several Broad Creek meetings, and it seemed like just about everybody they haul is either on Medicare or Medicaid.
Yes, sir, that is very true. That's true of our White Oak. Our White Oak, 70% of the patients that they haul that they get reimbursement for are Medicare and Medicaid. I already worked with Ricky White to get those numbers.
Okay.
So that does have a fiscal impact on us.
Sir, one question.
Yes, sir.
If a facility is designated H, as you would like to see, does that... give them the right to have blood at that facility?
Sir, if it's going to be designated as an emergent, full-fledged emergency department with a hotel designator, yes, sir, they'll have blood. That is one of the requirements.
Got you. Okay. Is there any other business we need to do at this time, Kenny?
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, just one thing. You just mention that blood again. Now, that was a big issue down in Bellhaven on Tuesday night. Should that be in the resolution about the blood? Okay. All right. Just heard blood and just hit my... Okay, good.
Anything else from any other commissioner?
Sure.
Mr. Manager.
I think you covered everything you intended to.
Okay. We appreciate everybody attending, and we will move forth as a committee, and we will do the best we can. Motion to adjourn.
Mr.